Hello, this is a quick video to show you how to prime and run the Belmont. So this is the Belmont. We have the touchscreen at the front of the machine. We have the cassette holder on the side. And on the back of the machine, you've got your on and off button, which you do have to press quite firmly to get it to hold. And you have your power cord, which should always be plugged in order for the Belmont to operate as it should. So here is the equipment that you need in order to set up the Belmont. You have the cassette, 3 bags of 250ml saline, and also a rapid infuser octopus, which is the only octopus that can be used with the Belmont. These are all obtained from the trauma towers kept in recess. Okay, so to load the cassette, you just need to take the black lever on the side of the Belmont itself, open the Belmont up, and take the cassette so that you've got the red arrow pointing to 12 o'clock and facing you. Pop that cassette into the machine and just make sure that you follow the red line and place the chamber just onto the chamber holder and just push this little tube into this black holder here. The next thing that we need to do is just ensure that we take this piece of clear plastic with the blue arrow on it, which sits on this little shelf here. So just pop that inside the Belmont and then bring this chamber up, connecting the chamber to the chamber holder. You'll see that there's a big blue line onto the actual cassette and there's a small blue line. Just make sure that you follow that on both sides. It's quite nicely painted there for you. So there's a big blue line and a small blue line. Once it's all in place, you'll be able to shut the Belmont door. And it doesn't click, it just safely secures that cassette in place. So now it's time to prime the cassette. First thing, you just need to make sure that you clamp off the spikes. That's just to ensure that we don't get air going in too early. Take your 3 bags of saline and make sure that you unclip each one of them. And just as you would if you were spiking an IV fluid bag, just be careful with the sharp, but just make sure that you put them in there nice and securely. So now we can fully prime the cassette. We just need to press the button on the back nice and firmly for when it turns on. Just allow it to go through its service interval first. There's a point to note on this that if you have turned on the machine before connecting anything up, as earlier in the video, it will instruct you anyway, so you haven't got to worry. But now you can unclamp all of those clamps that you clamped earlier on. That will fill the chamber up, but what you need to do is press prime. By pressing prime, you'll prime 100ml through to the actual cassette inside the Belmont itself. The Belmont will automatically stop once it has primed and removed all the air from inside the cassette. So once the cassette has primed, you now need to prime the patient line. So if you just press the patient line prime, it will prime the line nicely for you. Once it gets to the end, you'll just need to press stop. So now the Belmont is primed, we're ready to transfuse blood products. You need to disconnect the bag from the spike after clamping off, reconnect with your blood products, hanging the blood products and making sure you're unclamping there, and just press infuse. When you press infuse, you'll get a second screen that will come up. You just need to press the 500ml per minute button and that will start infusing at 500ml a minute, or as close as it can get. You'll see at the top here, it's telling you the rate that it's delivering, the temperature that it's warming up to, the pressure that it's detecting, and also the volume that has been infused so far. If anything throws an error, you can just simply press stop, and that will stop the infusion. To finish, there's a few things to note with the Belmont. You can only run FFPs and RBCs through the Belmont. Cryoprecipitate and platelets you cannot put through here. It also can't be run through an IO. If you're running through an IO, you would have to manually transfuse your blood. Please make sure that you plug it in at all times. If it's not plugged in, it won't warm to 37 degrees and it will also only run at 50ml per minute. If you get any errors come up on the machine, it will instruct you on how to change those errors and it's likely to be down to air. And again, it will instruct you on how to get rid of that air out of the machine. But that's everything.